lot of queries regarding the types of astigmatism. So let us make this clear one for all. Reading this question for you all, which of the following is an example of simple hypermetropic with the rule astigmatism? So all of you, to start with, what is astigmatism? So you all remember this? Have discussed this so many times in the class. If you all remember, more the curvature, more is the refractive power. We have discussed this many times. So if we apply this principle, more the curvature, more is the refractive power, right? So if you look at this cornea here on the left side, you see that the vertical and horizontal curvatures are equal. So this is not astigmatism. But in this right side, we see that this vertical is more than horizontal. So if there is difference of refractive power between the two principal axes, okay? So when there's difference of refractive power between two principal axes, this is what is astigmatism. And what are the principal axes? Commonly, it is always at 90 and 180. Of course, it may be different. We'll discuss that later. But what we have to learn at our level, it is 90 and 180. You can call it 0 or 180. Theek hai? Okay, so when we are talking about astigmatism, quickly, what is myopia, all of you? If you talk about other refractive errors, so quickly revise with me, myopia. I keep telling you M for M. Myopia is always more. So it is more power in the eye. Okay, so whatever power you require to focus the light rays on the retina, it is more than that, right? So this is what is myopia. The light rays are focused in front of the retina. What about hypermetropia? It is light rays are focused behind the retina. Hypermetropia means less power in the eye. So when the power required is, whatever I require, the power is less than that. Okay, less than the required. And hence the focusing is behind. Very good. So if we know what is myopia, hypermetropia, what is astigmatism? Coming further to this one, what is the problem in astigmatism? Very clearly we can see this here, it's very simple. So a patient with a normal eye sees this letter A so sharp and defined, but with astigmatic it is diffuse, very blurred. Why is it so? Because from one axis the focusing is at one point, from other at the other. So what you have to understand here, basic problem in astigmatism is that normally, the focal point is one focal point on the retina, but in astigmatism, there's more than one focal point. Is it okay? So this is the reason we see a blurred image. So the patient's complaint is blurred image, or you can say, sometimes you can say it's not well defined. So look at this one. So at night, when a normal patient is looking at these street lights, this is how it looks, you know, and headlights and streetlights, whereas when you come to this one, this astigmatic eye is seeing this all hazy, right? So this is the problem in astigmatism. You can be even more clear with the next slide. So if you see on the right side, this is a normal vision, a well-defined view can be seen, but here it is hazy through astigmatic eye. So this is the main problem in a patient with astigmatism. Okay, so once we know this, we have to learn what is the classification of astigmatism. We can classify astigmatism in four ways. What are the four ways? Here it is in front of you. So from one axis, the focusing is on the retina. That means here it is emmetropic. And the other is in front of the retina. Front means myopia. So this becomes simple myopic. Now, when one axis is behind the retina and one is exactly on the retina, this is simple hypermetropic. And if both, from both the axes, the focal points, the two focal points, focusing points are in front, it is compound myopic. And when it is both are behind, it is focused, both the light rays focus behind the retina, this is compound hypermetropic. And so sorry, and then what is mixed? One, from one axis, the focusing is in front, and from the other, it is behind. This is what is mixed astigmatism. Now, you can depict this in a very simple way. So let us see this slide. If one axis is no number, emetropia, one is a plus. This is simple hypermetropic. So now learn in my style, make it simple. One is emetropia and another is minus. This is simple myopic. If both are minus, this is compound myopic. Both are plus, compound hypermetropic. And if one is plus, one is minus, this is what is mixed astigmatism. What is the second way? The second way of classifying astigmatism is this. What is with the rule? What is against the rule? Okay, before you start reading that, look at me. What happens if there is a difference due to the pressure of the lids, due to this? Generally, the vertical is expected to be more than horizontal. And that is why we have termed it as with the rule astigmatism. So when vertical is more than horizontal, this is with the rule. But vice versa, when horizontal is more than vertical, now we will call it against the rule astigmatism. Okay, so all of you, again I'm repeating, why do we call with the rule? I explained you so that you will never learn reverse, and it will be easy for you to recall that with the rule means due to the pressure of lids, it should be the vertical which should be more than the horizontal. That is the rule. But when it is against, this is horizontal is more than vertical. This is what is called against the rule astigmatism. What is the third way of classifying astigmatism? The third way of classifying is oblique and bioblique. I just told you that majority of us have the principal axis at 90 and 180, correct? They are perpendicular to each other. Now suppose the two axes are still perpendicular but not at 90 and 180. This is what is oblique astigmatism. And if the angle between the two is less than 90 now, this is what is bioblique. So when they are not perpendicular and it is less than 90, we will learn it as bioblique astigmatism. Got it? Next we talk about after this is your third way of classifying. What was the first way? Simple hypermetropic, simple myopic, compound hypermetropic, compound myopic and mix. What was the second way? Against the rule, with the rule. What is the third way? Oblique and bioblique. What is the fourth way of classifying astigmatism? You have learned this with me also, earlier also. Regular and irregular. So here you see what I have shown you is, if this is on the vertical axis, I've shown you these points. These are the multiple points on a single axis. That's what I want to stress here. So if suppose I write here plus 2, that plus 2 is all over the vertical axis. This is what is regular astigmatism. But suppose even in the single axis, different points, the power is varying. If there is a variation in the power and it is not uniform throughout the axis, this is what is irregular astig. Suppose it was plus 2, now 0, plus 1. Okay, something like this. Then we call it as irregular astigmatism. And where do we learn irregular astigmatism? Please remember the most important example, keratoconus. Padhai na? Keratoconus. So these are the four ways of classifying. So now you know what is astigmatism. We have revised what is myopia, hypermetropia. We know how to classify astigmatism. We know how the patient will complain of due to astigmatism. Correct? And how do you treat? We treat with cylindrical lenses. What do I mean by that? So everybody knows that if I'm treating myopia, I use a concave lens to decrease the power. And how much I have to decrease the power will be the measure of my myopia. And that is why myopia is always indicated as minus. Okay, so when I say minus is myopia, right? So this is the question. Okay, let me complete what I was saying. What is hypermetropia? I said it is treated by convex lens. So how much I have to increase the power to treat this hypermetropia as measure of my? So that's why we always indicate hypermetropia as plus. How much plus I need to correct the hypermetropia? So it is always given as plus. So plus is hypermetropia, minus is myopia. Are we clear? What about astigmatism? How do we treat? We treat it with cylindrical lenses. What is a cylindrical lens? So cylindrical lens will always give the power in a single axis. Okay. A spherical gives the power in all the axes, all over. Okay. Just remember this much. The cylindrical will give the power in single axis and the rest will give in all over, right? Okay, so this is the question in front of you. What do we have to know here is, let's take one by one. We talk about the first prescription. It is plus 4 darter spherical, minus 3 cylinder at 90 degree, right? So when I say plus 4, minus 3 at 90, before I move further, all of you please keep this in mind. In any spectacle prescription, the axis is always mentioned opposite. What do I mean by that? That if I need the power at 90 degree, I will mention the axis 180. Here, if I'm saying 90 degree, that means the power has to be at 180. If I'm saying 180 degree, the power will go to 90. So all of you learn with me, along with me now itself, that axis in the cylinder is mentioned opposite. Any prescription, it is mentioned opposite. ठीक है? Now I know you are all tempted to ask, why ma'am, why it is opposite? Because cylindrical lens की बनावट ही ऐसी है, it is made in such a way that the power and axis are perpendicular to each other. If I need the power at 90, I have to put the axis 180. If I need the power at 180, I will put the axis at 90. So please remember, the cylindrical lens is such that the power and the axis are perpendicular to each other. Okay? Is it clear? That is why we always mention the axis as opposite. Okay, so now let us solve this. This was your first option. Plus 4 spherical means plus 4 is in both the axis. Minus 3 darter cylinder at 90. So that means minus 3 will be at 180. So my power will become here. What is the retinoscopy here? Plus 4 and plus 1. Now plus is hypermetropia, so we have written here compound hypermetropic. How do I say it is against the rule? So how do I say it is against the rule? This is because if this is plus 4, the actual power here is 60 minus 4. Isn't it? Because hypermetropia is less than required. So if you say 0 or emetropia is 60 darters, okay? If you say emetropic eye is 60 darters, plus 4 means what is the power in this eye? It is 60 minus 4. And what is the power in this eye with plus 1? It is 60 minus 1. Okay? So this is what is 60 minus 4 and 60 minus 1. So where is the power more? It is at the 180 axis. Therefore, we say against the rule astigmatism. Clear here? We come to the next prescription was this. This was your second option. Now, I think everybody can solve along with me very easy. Minus 3 spherical means both places minus 3. And when I say plus 2 cylinder at 180, it is at plus 2 will be kept at 90. So when it is kept at 90, it is 60 plus 1 and 60 plus 3. Got it? So when you say 60 plus 1 and 60 plus 3, where is the power more? Horizontal. So don't just read the answer. The WTR is wrong. It is ATR, against the rule. So I want you all to solve by yourself. That's why I deliberately written like this. So just to let you all know, just don't read the answer. Try to solve with me. Okay? So here it is. 60 plus 1, here it is 60 plus 3. Therefore, this is compound. Why compound? Because both are minus. Minus 1 and minus 3. Right? So naturally, minus 3 is more power. So, jitna when we increase in minus, power is more. Jitna we increase in plus, power is less. Theek hai? So it is opposite. Keep that in mind. So this is against the rule. I'm again correcting you all. It is not with the rule, okay? It is against the rule, astigmatism. So we will not read the answer. We'll solve for ourselves first. Okay, we come to the next one. Now is this next prescription was plus 2 spherical means both places plus 2. This time it is minus 2 cylinder at 90. So I keep this minus 2 at 180. Everybody is clear? 0. And plus 2, 0 is more because it is 60 darters, and plus 2 becomes 60 minus 2. So it becomes against the rule, and this is the answer of your question. Simple hypermetropic against the rule astigmatism. Okay, now we talk about next is the last is this one. If you look at this one, this plus 2 cylinder at 90. So we put that plus 2 at 180. So it is 0 at 90 and plus 2 at 180. It has to be with the rule astigmatism. It is simple hypermetropic. Okay, 1 is 0, 1 is plus 2. So it is simple hypermetropic. Okay, so now I think you are very, very clear on how to solve these questions. And you should be able to solve it yourself. Right? So please keep this in mind that whenever you are getting such questions, never answer just looking at the prescription. Always, all the time, turn it into retinoscopic reading. Take a minute, think, and then answer. You will never be wrong. It's not difficult at all. Okay? And I hope everybody is very clear. This is not with the rule. This is against the rule. Right? Why it is against the rule? Because PAR is more in the horizontal axis. Minus 3, PAR is more than minus 1. So we should answer not the WTR, it is against the rule. Yeah. This was all about astigmatism, and this is how you're going to solve the questions. Okay? Yeah. So let's try to discuss more interesting topics in the future videos. Right? Let us end with a thought for the day as usual. You know? So, what is the thought for the day for today for all of you? Yeah. So, let's apply. To build an invincible core itself is victory. Okay. So, invincible core, which never gets defeated, which never gives up. Remember what I say to you all? I will never disrespect myself by ever giving up. So, stay blessed. Be happy and keep smiling. Thank you.